Hi there, and welcome to Catchment of Resources. I'd like to introduce to you this application titled OpenFAST. For those who don't know about it, OpenFAST is an open source application which helps professionals to design onshore and offshore wind turbines. So it can help to design all the way from the wind turbine blades to the tower and down to the foundation. When it has to do with an offshore structure, it can also design a monopile or even a jacket. This application is open source, so it's free for everyone to use. There are several available applications which are actually expensive, but this is free to download and to use, and it has steady support from the producers, which is from National Renewable Energy Laboratory. This was a work which was developed by several professionals with the National Renewable Energy Institute, such as Jonkman, Butterfield, Musial, and Scott, and many others, just to mention a few. This OpenFAST documentation is based upon a definition of certain characteristics of the wind turbine. For example, we are talking about a 5 megawatt turbine, and this turbine has 63 meters radius of the blade. You can see a title here of the book, which can be downloaded in order to actually learn how to use this application as well as understand the design of the wind turbine. On the right is a cover of the documentation for the OpenFAST application. These titles, if you search online, you'll be able to get it to be able to obtain it for your own use. There are several ways to run OpenFAST, but in this video, we'll be looking at the approach of using binaries. Binaries are certain code which have already been prepared, and we are going to download them as well as run them using command prompt. Then we will see the result from the analysis of the wind turbine. So first of all, we start off by typing OpenFAST. When you do a Google search for OpenFAST, although I've been working on it previously, so you see when I search online on Google, you already see highlights of GitHub. But when you search online for OpenFAST, you are looking for this link, and then you select OpenFAST folder. From there, you can look at, if you scroll down, you look at the different components and different definition for the application. So this main file, you go to code, and then you download the zip folder. This is the first part of the download of the binaries. After this, if you look to the right, as highlighted, you are going to see OpenFAST releases, OpenFAST version 3.3. You are going to select this. When you select it, you can see different information being detailed. You can scroll down and read everything. There are several files to be downloaded. In order to do the basic running and testing of this application, you don't need all of the files. But so that in the future, you don't need to come back when you find some errors, when the command prompt is finding difficulty compiling some files, we'll download almost all of it, as you will see here. Then you go back to the home page again and you click on reg_test, and then you open the rtest folder. Then you go to the code and you download the zip folder. After downloading these files and folders, you will then need to unzip those two folders, the OpenFAST main folder as well as the rtest folder. After unzipping the files in the folder, you can then go ahead to test and see how the application works. In OpenFAST, there are different codes called glue codes which have been developed in order to design different types of wind turbine models. For example, you could have a wind turbine that's on a barge, you can have a wind turbine that's on a monopile, or you can also have a wind turbine that is on an onshore facility or offshore facility. So those different kinds of codes can be tested, which we will do in a moment. So one of the folders which contains input data for the different codes that they design the different models for the wind turbines is called the 5 megawatt baseline. So you have a 5 megawatt underscore baseline which has most of the input files that is used by all the other glue codes. As you can see, there's several folders here at different models for wind turbines. Most of them derive their primary input file from the 5 megawatt underscore baseline, although individually they have some unique codes to them that are also input files. But all of these models derive from the 5 megawatt underscore baseline folder. So you can open the folders and see what its content is. So we are going to run the application from command prompt. So I'm opening here a notepad so that we can copy the address of the file. For example, this openfast.exe, we need this file, so we need its location because we are going to be running the application from a different folder. So the next file we are going to run alongside the openfast.exe is the .fst file. In order to use the .fst file, we are going to make the particular model of the wind turbine that we want to test. We are going to make that folder the current directory. So when we make it the current directory, it makes it easier for us to just copy the title of the .fst file and place it beside the openfast.exe file and then run it in command prompt. So you see here we have used cd to make this file to be tested, the current directory, and then we copy the file from the .fst file, put it beside the openfast.exe file, we copy it and place it in the command prompt, and then we run. You can see on your screen that the different files inside the folders are updating and they are increasing in number compared to what you saw in the video initially. There are more files that have been generated. And you see the suffix of this folder or the extension of this folder, you see some of them having .sum, .out. Most of these files are like the summary of the design or the output files from the design we have just done. So in order to view these files, you can view both the input and the output files using probably, you can use Visual Studio or Visual Studio Code, which we are using here. So we are going to view the different results that have been obtained from running the OpenFAST application. So there are some programs that I've run in the past where it was giving me some error talking about the .dll files. The discon.dll files could not be found in the servo baseline folder. So you see here, I'm going to open the 5 megawatt baseline in order to put those files into the servo data. So each of the discon folders, I placed the corresponding .dll file inside it. It may not be an issue for you, I just said I should mention this because in order to troubleshoot the problems you will have along the way, you are going to have to do some unique things that are unique to the problem that probably from your file system arrangement. So you will need to do some rearrangement of some files, but it's not so difficult because when you run your program on the command prompt, it tells you the error and you're able to correct it if it's easy enough. There's also the forums and discussion platforms on the GitHub repository for the OpenFAST application, which you can also get some help because they also frequently ask questions on the platform. So we're opening the folder where we have our OpenFAST file, which we have just tested, in order to see the output. You can also see the input for any file or folder you want, but you can see here the various files we generated before. The .dat files, those are, most of them are input files. You can see here the .fst file, which shows some details of what the program was to run and how it is calling different files and folders in the process of running the application. So opening one of the output files, you can see here different details have been provided. This is from like an iteration process which shows the different steps and the different values being obtained until it converged. Then you can see here an output of Elastodyne which shows you like the tower, the values for the stiffness, the different values for the tower. Then BD1, which is the beam dyne, gives you the properties of the blade. It actually gives you the overall mass of the wind turbine blade, one of the blades. So there are different other models in this OpenFAST repository and glucose which help you to find out different properties of wind turbine blades. So that's basically it about OpenFAST and running it from the downloaded binaries. In the next video, we're going to look at how you can actually run OpenFAST by building a solution in Microsoft Visual Studio. Until next time, this is Cabinet of Resources, where we create for better living.